Okay, so I'm redoing video on how to wire up the order to wire up your distributor cap, the spark plug wires in your distributor cap that lead to as well as the order that they lead to your exhaust side and intake side, and as well as the exhaust side and the intake side for the ignition coils. It can all be confusing. The reason I'm redoing this is because when I did this last time, after I did it and uploaded it, it was bugging the heck out of me. It was just nagging me, because I didn't actually see the video after I uploaded it, but I looked at it last night to affirm what was bugging me about it. And like I said before, I really dislike giving wrong information, but let's get to it. I don't want to waste too much time. On this model, 8 spark plugs, but it's actually a 4-cylinder, even though it's got 8 spark plugs. 4 go for the exhaust side, which is a side. The intake side's on the other side. Okay. Here's where I blundered last time. Okay, so if you're doing this, if you have to do this, figure out the proper order. Say you change your distributor or just your distributor cap, or you're installing new spark plug wires. Two ways to do this so that you can get them right. The first would be snap a photo of the entire thing so you don't forget where everything goes. And the next thing would other way to do this is to change each wire at a time. You know, pull one out and change it, pull the next one out and change it, and so on until they're all done and right back to their proper order. But if you're lucky, your wires will be numbered and or labeled. These are labeled, which makes that job even easier, so you'll know which one to use and the proper length, because they're all different lengths. If you're looking at the distributor cap head on, this one right here, hopefully you can see me pointing at it. Not only is it labeled as the number one cylinder, or the spot for the number one, the wire, this spark plug wire that goes to your cylinder, number one cylinder on the intake side, we'll just follow it and we see it literally go to that spot. So I'll number them out, renumber them out the proper way this time. Okay, so this is intake 1, intake 2, intake 4, and intake 3. Sorry about that. Intake 3. Had to make sure I get them right. So one more time. Intake 1. This one right here. Intake 1. Intake 2. And you're essentially skipping a spot. So intake 1. Skip 1. Intake 2. Skip 1. Intake 4. Skip 1. And intake 3. and to find the exhaust side would be, it's actually just follow the same process. This spot right here is exhaust one. Skip one, exhaust two, which leads to your spot. Let's see. Gotta want to make sure I get this proper. So one, two, exhaust four, and exhaust three. So one more time. Exhaust one, skip. Exhaust two, skip. Exhaust four, skip. And exhaust three. And as far as the intake and exhaust for your ignition coils, this again it can be tricky if you've never done it or lose track of what's what. This bottom one is your exhaust side, and I'm purposely leaving that connected, and I'm leaving the top one is your intake, which would go here. But I'm going to show you another way, or two ways to know which is the proper spot for it. Okay, the exhaust, you will know it because it has, the harness has three wires. The intake side will have four. That's one way to know. The other way to know for sure, I'll try to explain this and hopefully it'll make sense. The reason this particular version of this, the Z24 engine has eight spark plugs, it's still a four cylinder, but it has eight spark plugs, and it has to do with emissions. Trying to remember exactly correctly, I want to give you guys the most accurate information. The exhaust intake side, or I'm sorry, the exhaust ignition coil, that I believe it runs at low RPMs, and once you start getting into high RPMs, where you know, where you're gunning it, you're out in the expressway or a highway, that's when the intake side takes over and lets you burn off your gas and all that, and lets it burn it off better. If that's not working, you'll have really bad gas mileage, and you'll be able to smell the, I believe you'll be able to smell the exhaust and the fumes. But again, the other way to know for sure that your exhaust side, again, the exhaust side is out of these two, it's the bottom one. If you're lucky, your distributor cap will be numbered, but sometimes they're not. But at least this way, you'll know for sure. So your exhaust has to go on this ignition coil, which is the one closest to your headlights. It'll be the one closest to it. The intake is the one closest to your firewall. But to know this for sure, to be like 100% sure, keep in mind, I don't have the intake side hooked up, and I'm doing that on purpose right now. But this is how you find out that you have your exhaust wire, ignition wire, hooked up to the proper coil. Your engine will start. If it's not, it'll just crank over and nothing will happen. As you can see, it's on.
and it's running without the the intake side. So that is how you know that your exhaust wire is hooked up to the proper ignition coil.
If you don't have that hooked up correctly, your engine will just crank over and nothing will happen. It won't actually start. So hopefully that makes sense. And I explained this better than I did in the previous one, because I totally messed up in the previous version of this. I was so focused on making sure that I got everything in focus that I missed the obvious, that I was pointing at the wrong wires to signify the wrong number. I was totally off, and didn't realize it in the moment. But again, it was just bugging the heck out of me in the back of my head. That something wasn't right, that I didn't explain something right. And when I looked at it last night, it was really late, it was just in my head. I'm looking over the video again, like, holy crap, I knew I'd done something wrong. But hopefully this is a better explanation, and this makes more sense. And it gives you more options to figure out how to hook up what to what, where it goes, and when it'll start and when it won't start. And the previous video, I already deleted it because, man, it was just bugging the heck out of me. But that was my fault, totally my fault. I should have paid more attention. But anyway, I will see you.